From the beginning, we were wrong. And only now, well into the second decade of the conflict, have we begun to understand the mistakes we have made. We lived in harmony among the Fae, in a world awakened to new magic. Perhaps we should have foreseen what might be born on this rising tide. What force might awaken? A force powerful enough to twist even the eternal and the mutable Fae folk. But Gadflo, the new king of the Winter Court, surprised us all. Singular among his people, he was all that other Fae were not. Aggressive, ambitious, visionary. He had power like none we had ever seen. Terrible and deadly. Gadflo and his followers, the Tuatha De Áon, believed that a new god was to be born in the east, beneath Gadflo's crystalline fortress of Amathen. In the name of that god, they marched to war against the young races of Amalur. Against a mortal army, no matter the power of their god, we might have been victorious. But the Fae are creatures of magic, not bound by the laws of life and death. Such two that are fallen on the battlefield would soon rise again, for the Fae do not know death as we do. How could we stand against such a force? For 10 years the war raged. For 10 years the armies of men and Alfar fought and died. But as our numbers dwindled, we knew that it was only a matter of time. Our fate had been written. At least, that is what we believed. Until you died.
What do you think this one is then? Alfar? Loran? Could even be a Jotun.
Always a surprise, eh, Garan?
Eyes on the job, boy. Don't matter what it is. Dead's dead. And be thankful for that. All we've seen. Go on and pull back the sheet, though. It'll need to be in our report, one way or the other. Varani. Must have been a mercenary, come to fight in the war. I could have told him how he'd end up. Not in bad shape though, all things considered. All right then, make sure it goes into the report. You know he'll want all the details.
Amazing how well the body held up. Better than I've seen.
I'm just glad it's not moving. Must have been born under a lucky star, this one.
Anything else we need?
Unless you'd like to name him, I think we're done. Put him with the others.
Well, that's it for you then. Better luck next time.
Thank you. over. Run!
Scatter, children of dust! Scatter before the might of the Tuatha!
Stay away!
I dust shall escape.
Help! Anybody!
You! Up there! Please help me! Please!
More mortals. Oh, thank you. Thank you. If you hadn't come along, wait. I've seen you before. On the slab. You were dead. It worked. By the tome, it worked. You're alive. No, clearly not anymore, but you were. The Well of Souls remade your body. We thought you were another failure. But the well restored your soul to your body, and it worked. We must get you to Professor Hughes right away. He'll have questions for you. Professor Formerus Hughes, the Well of Souls is his life's work. The Tuatha are coming into the lower levels. If we hurry, we should be able to beat them to the top. Take these. They'll help keep you safe long enough to get to Hughes. Now, let's get going! Oh, my. You don't know? Perhaps the process damaged your memory. They are the Tuatha De Oum, the enemy of all the young races. We've never seen them this far inland. Not even during the invasion. I don't know why they're here. I wish I could tell you more. You showed no signs of life when we removed your new body from the well's waters. We just put it in the furnace room with the others. We would have never done that if we knew. The Well of Souls is just ahead. You'll see. And it works. It restored you to life. There will be plenty of time to explain later. We've got to get going. Let me get this door, and we can be on our way. Right this way. You go first. This is what they're after. Our greatest invention, the Well of Souls. Imagine an end to war, an end to death. the storerooms. See if you can find anything useful. Wait! Do you hear something? Shoot them before they see us. tigers are deadly if you catch an enemy unaware. Their speed more than makes up for their size. More up ahead. If you can sneak up on them with your daggers, you should be able to finish them quickly and quietly.
Look at the mortal vermin scatter.
Blossoms only respond in the presence of magic. Perhaps there is more to you than it seems.
Thank you.
I bet you're still groggy, but just keep moving! Move! Move! They've completely covered the tunnel! Maybe you can use that staff to burn a path through. Not more spiders! Burn them! Burn them! Get out of here!
Bastard!
Wait,
you're not one of them. Ezio, yet alive! And who is this?
That's what I intend to find out. He came out of the well.
What? Then he'd better get inside to see the old man. Quick, before those Quatha make another push.
This is where we part ways. Take whatever you want from this armory. We might have a few things that would fit you. Oh. Just make sure you get your shoes. We can hold off the Tuatha here. There's nothing more I can do except to stay here and slow down the Tuatha. But this is the armory, after all. Check the chests. We might have a few things that would fit you. With luck, I'll see you on the outside. I'll see you on the outside, if fate wills. Plate armor. Nothing protects quite like layers of impervious metal. Leather armor is thin, but will give you the speed to reach an enemy's boat. Simple cloth frees your body and mind. That's why mages prefer it. You've made it! And look at you! Even with all you've been through, the Tuatha, your return from the dead... Please forgive me. You must be terribly confused by all of this. I am Fomorous Hughes, and this is my laboratory at Alistar. Everything you see here is dedicated to one thing, the Well of Souls, the pursuit of immortality. And you, you're my first success. If we only had the time, there's so much we might learn from one another. I wish I could tell you more, but your death is a mystery to me as well. It seems that your memory died with your body. You see, the well is designed to capture the soul of someone recently deceased, recreating their physical form within its waters. Simple, really. Your rebirth is the first we might truly call a success. There have been others, but the results weren't quite right. Too much to explain right now. The Tuatha have come to stop my work, but I don't believe they know about you. Not yet. What's important is getting you out of here safely. You're the only proof of what we've achieved here. I may not be able to save the well, but I can ensure that its only success is safe. We're in the Feylands, miles away from the front lines. I thought we were safe enough from the war, but it seems some of the Tuatha found their way here anyway. Absolutely not. I've got my notes, but it's most important that you stay safe. It's just that you're... Fascinating. Simply astounding. I'm not certain what's caused it, but somehow... Yes, as I was saying, I'm not sure what... Perhaps I should go see.
Sir! Sir! Mr. Hughes! The Tuatha have reached the lab! They're inside the...
No! We've got to get you out of here now! Quickly! Follow the path to the town of Gorhart. Find Agarth. He's a friend, and he may be able to help. No matter what else, stay alive!
Go!
Oh.
another survivor. But I've never seen you in the tower. Were you one of the professor's assistants in the downstairs projects? Did he escape with you? That sounds like him. Professor Hughes was very thoughtful. I mean, he is very thoughtful. I'm sure he found a way to get out. He must have! We should be safe here. At least,
I told them we needed more guards.
You've come from the tower, haven't you? Name's Agarth. Maybe you can help an old fate weaver, eh?
Fate weavers look at the great tapestry of fate. The threads will tell us how a life will unfold. But knowing the future and being able to change it are two very different things. Did he? Poor old Fomaris Hughes. He respected the way the world works. What a shame. He's probably dead by now. The cards told me that the Well of Souls would work, but Hughes' success would come on the day of his death. He took it pretty well, honestly. Although we did a lot of drinking after that. You're the one. Then that means it all makes sense now. The cards this morning. I drew the Gravedigger, the Running Man, and the Beast. Prepare yourself. They're coming. Threads of fate. I've seen them before, but I've never seen anyone manipulate them like that. You just changed how the world was supposed to work. How did you do that? Fate is the will of the gods. No mortal should be able to change it. How is that even possible? Come here. I'm going to do a reading. You might be able to change the threats, but fate will still have a plan for you. I promise not to tell you if I see your death. It's a gift. Some people paint landscapes, other people write poetry. I peer into the weave of fate's tapestry and see people's deaths. That would be my guess. He was an academic, but he had a proper respect for fate's plan, unlike most gnomes. You're nervous. Relax. This is what fate weavers do. I'll be seeing your place in the pattern of destiny. Who you are, what you've done, where your path takes you. Or, at least, I should be. You're real, right? I swear, I haven't had that much. Fate's weave is always hard to see. It's in motion, hard to make out, but undeniably there. Yours is just missing. This doesn't make sense. All mortal creatures have a place in the pattern. You should have one too, dead or not. If this is true, and I'm not saying I believe it, then your path is yours to determine.
Thank you.
I can see the threads around you, but they're shifting, changing so rapidly, I can't make sense of them. Normally, the threads would guide my hand to the cards, and I'd use those cards to see your pattern in the weave. But it just didn't happen. They wouldn't focus. So either there's something wrong with me, and there isn't, or there's something very wrong with you. It could mean nothing, or it could mean everything. The world is changing. You might be a sign of that, or maybe the cause. I've never had a reason to doubt my own readings, but we should consult with Arden. He's not a friend, but he's got a good eye for the tapestry. I'll meet you at his home to the east. I'm going to see if I can be of any help to the wounded at the tower. That's just it. I don't know if you've got one, but that's why we're going to see Arden. He lives in a little hut to the east in Yulven. I'll meet you there. What could this all mean?
In halls of lore, there echoes none more grand than Olane's many feats of might, the pure and lady of the light. She is a knight of golden knot. She is the cure seeker, the conscience of the summer fay. She is the heart of spring, of day.
Everyone just stand back. The warden can't work when you're crowding so close. Oh. Go back to your business. Go on.
I'm so tired.
Oh. Greetings.
Good day.
Interesting. You're not at all what I expected to find here. Oh, is that the name of this Fate Weaver? No, the Tuatha I was following killed him. I was hoping his corpse would give me an idea why they were here. Now I know. They were hoping to find you. Oh, no reason. At least not one you have to worry about. If I'd interfered, the Tuatha would know I was tracking them. This Fate Weaver wasn't worth losing valuable information. But the Tuatha are still on the move. I must go. I'm certain we will see one another again. Soon. Be on your way.
What happened here? Auron's dead. How did this happen? Why would they have come here? Why kill a harmless old Fate Weaver? They couldn't know that you were headed here. I mean, the stingy bastard owes me a week of drinks. Doesn't mean he deserved to be murdered. I was hoping to avoid this, but I think I'm going to have to take you to Delok. It's a sacred place to we Fate Weavers. Somewhere that I was hoping to avoid. I was hoping Arden could take you, but I guess it comes down to me. No reason getting anyone else killed over it. Go, I'll meet you there. Once I give Arden a proper funeral. This is twice now I've buried the bodies left in your wake.
told of ancient days when wise priestess Beala Tirin to goddess Lyria spoke. The people, remembering all after war, called for Durek's fate. Slay them, the foul and wretched tribe, said Dokkhalfar. Spare them, the poor and miserable beasts, cried Losulfar. Their minds, depraved and hatred-poisoned, twisted. Alfar struck Alfar over drink, at feast, when all else is merry, when peace reigns in havens. Hateful, I am told, were cousins towards each other. From the cold-blessed Firial, Beala Tirin, with a head to seek Lyria's guidance, set forth on a pilgrimage.
Destroyer of Infamony.
It's good you're here. I was beginning to think you were just something I saw in the bottle. Welcome to the ruins of Delok. Because for some reason, you can change fate. In here, I can get a glimpse of the whole of the Weave and see where you should fit in. We'll see soon enough. Deep below us is the Theater of Fate, where the Immortals taught man, Alphar, and Gnome to read the destiny of the world. Come with me. Maybe I am crazy, but not about this. In we go. Ever since this place was abandoned, strange beasts have moved in. Stay close. This place has been abandoned for so long that some Fate Weavers think it's just a legend.
Keep quiet. We aren't safe here.
Stay close. It's the root. I'm hoping that the stone will tell me who you are.
Oh,
The theater can show us the whole tapestry of fate laid bare. We can do nothing to change it or prevent its horrors. Well, most of us can. After all those years of hiding in a bottle, it's good to see some action again. If only one last time.
Yeah.
Almost there, or at least as far as I can take you. I've seen this. This moment. I'm sorry, Ruth. This is as far as I can take you. Do you have any idea what you've done? What sort of power you're playing with? You absorbed everything he was, everything he would do. You changed the weave of destiny itself. Because of you, there are deeds he won't do. Children of his that won't be born. Victims that won't die when they were supposed to. Yes, I'm aware. But there's still no telling what damage you could do if you aren't careful. You're much more dangerous than I thought. We need to get you to the Theater of Fate right away.
Your future is far from you!
The theater of fate. I never thought I'd see it. Fate Weavers never fully understood the power of this place. Seems there's a lot we don't understand. Gods, I should have brought another bottle. Surprise an Iskaru found its way to this place of power. Everything about these ruins is dedicated to this room, and at the center of it all is the Destiny Stone. With it, the Fae taught the Fate Weavers the answers to the deepest mysteries of fate. Put your hands on the stone, and maybe we can find answers to your own mysteries. Destiny Stone came apart at your touch, and all around you the tapestry of fate, unweaving itself. And there at the core was the Codex of Destiny, the wisdom that the Fae used to help the first Fate Weavers understand the nature of the weave. Don't you see what this means? Ha! A small price to pay for the Codex of Destiny. If we can find a way to read that, it might help us understand something about you. But for now, just understand this. You're changing the fate of everyone you meet. That could make you more powerful than anything that's walked this world. No. You can still die or fail. But fate doesn't enforce the weave on you. Your gift is freedom, to you and to those around you. And that means I owe you a... Wait, what's that?
Purge the abomination! In the name of Gathlaw!
Dear God,
this looks like some fun.
We know you're not working with the Tuatha.
I don't care if you trust me. I'm much more interested in your friend here. You're welcome.
Wait a minute.
I'm beginning to think that these Tuatha don't like you. Now, why do you think that might be? After all, someone who can change the fate of the world, who wouldn't want you? I'm not sure, but they're very well informed about your location. They came straight here from Dydenhill, but they're not nearly as interesting as you. Especially now that they're dead. Now it's my turn. Why are you here? Ha! Knowing the future is for fools. Who reads the end of a book before it's time? Save your attention for the present. Like that codex you found? Our scholars thought those were all gone from the world. But you're just full of surprises. Good luck understanding it. That's Fey knowledge. They don't even have a written language. The stone is simply embedded with what they know, unseeable to mortals. Normally, I'd suggest looking in Issa, but the Fey are not fond of unexpected guests. But don't look so sad. There's still hope. When you're ready, meet me at the House of Ballads. Be on your way.
We can't trust her. Never met a Dugalfar who'd give me a straight answer, even with a sword at their throat. But she wasn't wrong about that codex. Just be careful doing anything she suggests. Meanwhile, we can't just ignore the Tuatha that are tracking you. We need to do something about them. She said they came through Dydenhill, didn't she? They don't belong in these lands, so they probably left a trail wide as an Eden's backside. Meet me there, and we'll track them down. Maybe we can find out why they're after you, or at least how they can find you so easily. I've got some final rites to perform before I leave this place. Good luck.